Good morning, dear students. In the last class, we have discussed about the extracting metal towards the law of the activity series. Okay, law of the activity series metals are we can extract by the reduction process. Okay, cinnabar is a ore of mercury, so that can be extracted by their oxides. Okay, mercuric oxide. From the mercuric oxide, on heating, we can reduce with carbon, means we have to obtain pure mercury, pure metal we have to obtain by the reduction method. Okay, today I am going to discuss about the extracting metals towards the top of the activity series metals. Extracting metals towards the top of the activity series. Next, extracting metals towards the middle of the activity series metals is there. I will explain next class in the about the middle of the activity series metals, but today I am going to discuss about the extracting of metals towards the top of the activity series. Okay, here extracting metals towards the top of the activity series, already we know the highly reactive metals. What are the highly reactive metals? Sodium, potassium, calcium, these are the highly reactive metals. These are the top of the activity series metals. The metals high up in the reactivity series are very reactive. Already we know that is a very reactive. They cannot be obtained from their compounds by heating with carbon. Okay, in the law of the activity series metals, we can obtain by the reduction. Okay, by the, on heating. Reduction with carbon also we done. Here, highly reactive metals, they cannot be obtained from their compounds by heating with carbon. For example, carbon cannot reduce the oxides of sodium, magnesium, calcium, aluminium, etc. Okay, before that, carbon is reduced the mercury and some other metals. Why? Because they are low reactivity metals. But here we did not use the carbon. Okay, for the extracting of highly reactive metals from their compounds by heating with carbon. Okay, for example, carbon cannot reduce the oxides of sodium, magnesium, calcium, aluminium. That carbon cannot reduce the oxides of sodium, magnesium, calcium, aluminium to the respective metals. This is because why that carbon is not going to reduce the highly reactive metals. This is metals, these metals having more affinity for oxygen than carbon. Highly reactive metals are more affinity to the oxygen than carbon. Okay, compare than carbon, this highly reactive metals, top of the activity series metals are more affinity with oxygen than carbon. These metals are obtained by electrolytic reduction. Okay, top of the activity series metals are, how can we obtain? By the electrolytic reduction. By the, we have to obtain the highly reactive metals by the electrolytic reduction. Okay, for example, sodium, magnesium and calcium are obtained by the electrolytic electrolysis of their molten chlorides. Here, sodium, magnesium and calcium is there. They are obtained by the electrolysis of their molten chlorides. Already we know the about the molten state. Okay, that means fusion state. Solids are converted into the liquids by heating. That is called molten state. Okay, so sodium, magnesium, calcium are obtained by the electrolysis of their molten chlorides. This sodium highly reactive metals are we can obtain from their molten chlorides on electrolysis method. Okay, the metals are deposited at the cathode. The metals are deposited at the cathode. Cathode means cathode having which charge? Negatively charged electrode. Cathode is a negatively charged electron. Okay, the metals are deposited at the cathode, that is negatively charged electrons. Whereas chlorine is liberated at the anode. Chlorine is liberated at the anode. Okay, anode means positively charged electrode. Anode means positively charged electrode. Cathode means negatively charged electrode. Negatively charged electrode is the cathode. and positively charged electrode is the anode. Okay, the highly reactive metals sodium, magnesium, calcium are obtained by the electrolysis of their molten chlorides. From the their molten chlorides only we can obtain the these pure metals by the electrolysis method. Okay, here at the anode, chlorine is liberated at the anode and metals are deposited at the cathode. Metals are deposited at the cathode and chlorine is deposited at the anode. Cathode is a negative charge, anode is a positive charge. Okay, next, at cathode, what is the reaction at the cathode? Already we know the at the cathode. Cathode means negatively charged electrode. Okay, pure metal, the metals are deposited at the cathode. Here we have to take this sodium. Sodium plus electron gives rise to sodium. Here sodium is getting one electron and converted into the sodium metal. Sodium ion is taking one electron and changes into the sodium metal. And next one, at anode. Anode means positively charged electrode. Here two chloride ions, negatively charged ions, is two chloride ions gives rise to Cl2 plus two electrons. It will be lost the two electrons. Here sodium get the electron. Here chlorine lost the electron and sodium get the electron. Okay, similarly aluminium is obtained by the electrolytic reduction of aluminium oxide. Similarly, aluminium is also obtained by the electrolytic reduction of aluminium oxide. Okay, now let us discuss about the refining of metals. Okay, refining of metals. How can we refine the metals?